That makes for good offensive game.
For the North, they have two fine QBs as well, Dave Barr and Eric Bjornsson, and they're a little bit different in style, aren't they?
Yes, they are, Jeff. They will drop back, and Bjornsson being the bigger of the two, they will drop back, read the defense, and throw the ball more like a pro set. Both are very fine quarterbacks.
Of course, in an all-star game,
to Washington State in the Pac-10. One-point lead in this ballgame for the South. 1:27 left in the game. Time enough for the North to win it. Bjornsson hands it off. Torrey, the ball carrier. 1:18 remaining in the game. Eric Bjornsson at quarterback for the North. Rushing in motion. Bjornsson to Hines, complete. He's down at the 20-yard line. They've got to hurry. Deion Johnson, Bobby Sylvester there defensively for the South. Hines wide right. Charlie Williams wide left. Hatzenbuehler, Torrey split behind Bjornsson. Throws to Williams, complete. Williams down the far side. He's inside the 5-yard line. And he gets out of bounds to stop the clock, showing 1:02. Manning and Lopez in on the stop defensively.
Great offensive design. Bjornsson showing you why he's a great quarterback. He goes to Hines and he goes to the next receiver. And he has no problem just moving the ball down the field.
So the North in good shape. First and goal from the 5, and a timeout called, stopping the clock with 57 seconds left in the game.
You know, after McDonald made that last reception and Hines made the one before, now the defense is pretty worried, but this is the time you can go with the blitz, the stunts, everything. It's no more than a timing pattern here. Bjornsson looks down, sees McDonald. See, McDonald goes, pushes the guy back, gets the ball. Let's make it one-on-one, guy, because this is the way we like to play. The big guy just goes right down the field. They're inside the 10, so everything goes on defense. Man-to-man,
Struther to the South. Struther in the backfield now. Rushing the ball carrier, trying to get outside. He's into the end zone. Touchdown for the North, and they go back on front. John Rushing scores his second touchdown of the game for the North squad. That makes it 19-14 North.
Bjornsson gives the ball to Rushing, who's the motion man. Gives him a, he's running full tilt before anyone else. He just gets around the corner, and he barely makes it in. Touchdown, North.
You can dive in here real quick. On
Dave Baronio, he's from the Vacaville Reporter.
Okay. Introduce yourselves, young fellow. These are two players last night in the high school all-star game, the North-South game. Their coach said they were standouts. The North, usually on the short end of the South, but they were victorious last night, 19-14.
I'm Eric Bjornsson from Bishop O'Dowd.
All right, quarterback.
And Dave Barr from Concord High.
And both these two young fellows were quarterbacks last night. In fact, Bjornsson, you led with 52 seconds to go in the game, the drive which put the North over. Congratulations. And this is the big all-star game, Bob. It's the 39th annual. And real quick, where are you headed to play college ball?
University of Washington.
All right.
In Cal Berkeley.
Okay. Well, congratulations, fellas. Like they said, they had a real nice coach. To get them on right at the end just to say hi. But congratulations, fellas. And when you strike it big in college, you're back on with Mr. St. Clair.
Right.
All right. Bob, have a good time in Canton.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Thank you.
For the fellas, Mr. St. Clair, and of course, Don Robinson, I'm Gary Radnich. Again, we look forward to Canton, Ohio, and Bob St. Clair's induction Saturday in the Pro Football Hall of Fame. Good night, everybody.
Breaking ball.
And something you don't see very often, JR wearing a hat.
No, he just took it off the way.
That's right.
made a liar out of you, Steve.
Well, he's over there in the sun, so he's going to probably use it part of the time. Washington first and 10. They have it for their second possession, and they're at their own 14. Hewitt with a quick drop and a completion to Bjornsson. And a big first down gain up near midfield. Micah Phillips, number 27, drags him down. But last year's co-quarterback, Eric Bjornsson, with a big reception and a gain of 34.
Bjornsson started at quarterback against USC in the second last game of the season last year. And you can see he gets behind double coverage. His safety, Micah Phillips, 27, does not get over in time. He's supposed to back up the quarterback on that play. So it works well for Washington.
First down, Washington now their own 48. Kaufman in motion. And he'll set up as a wide receiver. Blitz on. Hewitt gets it away and completes it. Bjornsson breaks a tackle. Bjornsson inside the 20. Touchdown, Washington.
A 52-yard touchdown pass. And even though Brian Williams of USC was in Hewitt's face, he got it away to Erik Bjornsson, who outran everybody.
Tell you what, Napoleon Kaufman split out to the right side. He was used as a decoy and drew a lot of coverage. Napoleon Kaufman's on the right side. Hewitt sees he's matched up with a cornerback. He goes left with the football. See how he makes the decision to go back. And Bjornsson does an excellent job of splitting two defenders who do not get there in time, and he has the speed to get into the end zone. Big play by the Huskies.
Sophomore John Wales on to attempt the extra point. Bjornsson is the holder. Not a good snap, but they get it up and through, and it is good. 11:31 left to go in the first. Hewitt to Bjornsson, and Washington leads it 7-0. Second and 10. Gets away from the pressure and completes it to Erik Bjornsson, who steps out of bounds at the USC 37. Micah Phillips, number 27, had the coverage, but it's first down to Bjornsson. Bjornsson. Willie Lowry almost got Hewitt.
Sorry, excuse me. Bjornsson having himself quite a day, and Hewitt showing some pocket. That's what allows him to get the football to Bjornsson as he on the sideline, gets both feet down.
And he
40 on the last down, second down. Expect to see him coming again on third. Challenge it on to Bjornsson. He makes the catch this time at the 39-yard line, and he's got the first down. Andy Colbert, who is 5'8" and 165 pounds, was on the coverage. Well, and he's got to respect Bjornsson. He's got to give him a cushion because he's out there by himself. But take a look at Edwards, outside linebacker in a stand-up position. He's going to come on an inside blitz, and they just kind of slide the line down. Everybody picks up. There's a man on a man in there, and you can see Kessie's in there. He's going to make sure that
Edwards...
Kessie's
beating up on him.
Yeah, don't want him anywhere near the quarterback after that first sack in the first quarter.
Bjornsson's a great story. A former quarterback here, moved to wide receiver, battled with Hewitt last year. They shared playing time, but strictly a wide receiver this year as Kaufman tries the middle. And nothing there that time is Rod Smalley, the in man. The Huskies have second and 10 at the 39-yard line. Staggered backs with Kaufman and Thomas. And Hewitt in the short drop, sending it to Bjornsson. Inside the 40, down to the 36-yard line. And the mismatch there, the 6'5 Bjornsson against the 5'8" Andy Colbert.
I'll tell you what, Napoleon Kaufman did a great job picking up the blitz, first of all. Watch to the right of your screen. Donnie Edwards, the best pass rusher, is going to get picked up by Kaufman. That allows Hewitt to stay right in the pocket and make the throw against man-to-man coverage. A great throw and catch, Hewitt to Bjornsson. But credit Napoleon Kaufman staying in there and picking up the blitzing linebacker.
Stadium, third down and 7. That was the first time out for Washington. UCLA has burned two of their timeouts here in the first half. Hewitt looking near side, and that's Bjornsson who makes the catch, and he has it up for the first down. They will spot it at the 48-yard line. Andy Colbert was there on the coverage, and Todd, that should be there all day, 6'5 against 5'8".
Yeah, and you got to give him a little bit of respect because coming into the game, averaging nearly 30 yards a reception, so he's been making some big plays. Got to give him a little bit of room, and nice target, throwing a little out route. And that time they kept Bruner, their best receiver, their top receiver. They kept him in to block, maximum protection, through to the one-on-one coverage outside.
First is away from his history degree in 3 years, and he's going to get a double major in sociology. As 37, Hewitt will go over to the far side, and Bjornsson is right there. And that's been his money guy today. That has been the money guy today, because I think what UCLA is doing is they're taking Bruner out of the game.
Yeah, well, Bruner's staying in to block a lot. They're doing a lot of maximum protection, just going two-man routes. And right now, Bjornsson is really having a field day against Andy Colbert out there. Again, you mentioned the size differential, but Bjornsson doing a nice job showing one thing, breaking, make some nice breaks to the outside, and giving a nice target to the quarterback. And Heward throwing the ball where it has to be. When you throw those out routes, you got to keep it to the outside. Don't want to get it back in where the defender is.
Bjornsson, four receptions, 57 yards, and Heward, after missing his first four, has now got it going as he checks off.
All right, thanks, Gary. You know, it'll be interesting to see what his confidence factor is as a head coach in his kicker in the second half. If this ball game stays close, does he make some decisions to go for it on fourth down here in the second half, trying to get touchdowns instead of relying on that field goal?
Well, on third down and sticks, let's see if they can find Bruner. He's been the third down man this year, but instead there's Bjornsson wide open and makes the catch at the 35-yard line, where Paul Guidry came over to give him the big hit as Bjornsson had to slow down but had his man beat. And Bjornsson's been the go-to guy to get today for the Huskies.
Yeah, I think everybody is expecting Bruner to be the guy that's going to get the throws, particularly on third down, but they're staying, keeping him in to block. Pretty good design. They're going to Bjornsson. They're going with the pump fake a couple times. You can see him working on Teddy Lawrence. Teddy Lawrence bit on the pump fake. They really worked him over on the outs. First play out of the box in the second half, they go out and up, and Bjornsson wide open.
32 yards in the pickup. You know, he's a better athlete than most quarterbacks.
And has been fine ever since. That's a lot of times to be carried off the field. Third down and four as they send Janoski to the left side with Bjornsson to the right with the all Pac-10 Craig Newsom going against him. That's a great battle, isn't it? Check off. Here comes Lucas, gets away from trouble, throws, complete. Eric Bjornsson, first down, up at the 39-yard line, going against that very same preseason All-American, Craig Newsom.
I love it. Damon Heward, everybody talks about how his foot speed is, but I'll tell you, right here, Dan Lucas has a beat on him. Whoa! Damon, good job of avoiding the sack.
He's running all those options in the red zone. That's what's doing it for him.
He looked quick enough on that play.
First and 10 for the Huskies. 75 career receptions as a Husky. Bjornsson. What a pass and great timing! Down to the 31-yard line of Arizona State going against Newsom. That was a beautifully timed pass to Bjornsson.
That's what all that hard work and practice will do for you, Don. A quick little play action. You know when you come up, you're going to set your feet solid, deliver the football. And Eric Bjornsson absolutely turned Craig Newsom around.
And that ball was halfway there before Bjornsson even made his cut.
You have to throw that ball when Eric is still, his shoulder pads are still going east and west.
Bjornsson coming in with 17 receptions in this game, in this season. Had five last week, which...
To drop off and play three-man deep zone.
They're down in five. Yeah, they like to pick their spots. This is just flat out one-on-one, and Bjornsson wins as he gets the first down against the freshman, Jason Simmons. First and 10 at the 39 of Arizona State as Eric Bjornsson just keeps on catching the ball.
I tell you what, I'd go to this well all day until they stop this. They have not covered this route at all. We've done it against the other side, against Newsom. There, Simmons, the freshman. I'd do it until they stop it.
Three today for 32 yards and is still averaging almost 20 yards. Heward, Bjornsson, first down. That's inside the 45 of Arizona State. Holds on to the ball and comes down to a gentle arrival to the earth. Craig Newsom there defensively. Just gently laid down on the
carpet. Yes, he did. This ball looked like it was just floating out there. It stayed up there a long time. Eric able to maintain positioning on Newsom.
And the forward progress that got it down to the 44 of Arizona State. Scott Linehan gets it back now to the original line of scrimmage. Gain of only about 5 yards, they call it, as Jason Simmons was defending. So it's going to be third and long. Third and seven, to be exact.
We've only had one throw to our tight end today.
Wide receiver to each side. And they throw again. Bjornsson complete at the 30-yard line is tattooed, but not until he gets the first down. And that sets a career high for Eric Bjornsson.
Washington with 6 receptions in a game. Jason Simmons defensively.
See Damon looking downfield. He knows where he's going. Eric's going to be open on the left-hand side of the screen. Absolutely turned him around. Jason Simmons didn't know where he was. Great catch.
Bjornson with his 4th touchdown in 94.
On the left hand of the screen, one-on-one, Craig Newsome, number 7, too much of a cushion there. I love to see him throwing this route. This really keeps the defenses honest. They've been setting up all day, going straight downfield, and this time he broke it off to the middle.
And that's quite a statement, too. You're putting your best against their best cornerback in Newsom, the preseason All-American. They're going for 2. Richard Thomas, 1st and 10 from 4. You were throwing a lot today. Bjornson! 1st and goal, Washington, at the 9-yard line. Jason Simmons, the cornerback, is going to go to sleep seeing number 14 running circles around him.
Well, defense is starting to hone up down there on our tight ends. And here's a chance for Bjornson to get wide open on the corners.
Let's get the numbers on him for the day. He has had a terrific afternoon.
Well, there's an experience by a cornerback, Jason Simmons. That wasn't
history in the making. Eric Bjornson just keeps upping that career high day with his 9th reception and the 1st down to the 33-yard line.
Just keep doing it. Been there all day.
Wonder if Bruce Snyder is wondering when Lambright is going to pull the plug and put in the 2nd unit.
Mr. Thomas can catch the football. Heward. Now they go deep to Bjornson, and this ball is caught. Bjornson is going to score for the touchdown as the Huskies go deep, 51 yards, and they're right back in it.
Great throw by Heward, nice catch. I think the Huskies caught the free safety, Jeff Sherman, a little bit flat. You'd like to think with the ball in the air that long, your free safety could get over there and be a factor. Such was not the case.
Bjornson not known for running the deep pattern, but he's a pretty fast guy. In this game a year ago, he was the backup quarterback. And now he's the holder on the PAT attempt. And this one is up and good. Well, a couple of pretty good defenses getting shocked this afternoon. Already a total of 24.
Offensive brain trust is content, you know, to get the sticks moving, not try for the big play right away.
Bjornson and Janoski split off to the left. Near side, it's Fred Coleman. Heward, good time. Throws the out, caught by Bjornson, and he's tackled and got out of bounds at the 32-yard line. It's a gain of 7. Herman O'Berry knocked him out. An injured Oregon player, I think that's Mark Schmidt, at the 15-yard line.
Washington did come from behind.
Crowd on the opposite side of the field, waving those pom-poms. About 25,000 pom-poms being waved right now. 2nd and 3 for the Huskies. Heward, pressured, gets away. Throws it, caught by Bjornson. 1st down and more. Bjornson into Oregon territory at the 45. Jeff Sherman knocked him down, but it's a Husky 1st down. The clock stopped, 2:12 to play.
Great block by Dave Janoski downfield for the Huskies.
With 3 timeouts, the Huskies don't really need to go into the hurry-up offense, but they will use one of their timeouts right here, it looks like. Well, maybe not. Maybe they won't have to.
Yes, they did.
Yeah, they did.
Maybe the only way they get it to them is on a quick screen or that kind of thing.
You see how many defensive backs the Oregon Ducks put in there?
Maybe 11.
Do they have the nickel and dime packages? I'm sure they do.
Well, they got the $0.50 in there now.
This is $1.50, and there's 6 guys in there. Well, whoever's out there has to be a good tackler.
They have six DBs in there. A dime package.
Here's the out pattern to Bjornsson. He's got it. First down, Huskies, 31-yard line.
And he gets out of bounds.
They went to the money man.
Well, we talked about that, Todd. I tell you what, that's all that hard work this summer's paying off right now. Tremendous throw. Great throw by Damon Huard.
Pretty good coverage by Molden, but this is a big guy, and he's got good body position.
You got to think, though, if it's fourth and 10, though, Kenny, that that receiver's going to be somewhere where those stakes are.
You almost have to throw it at least 10 yards. You take a chance and throw a five-yard pass. And he...
So, second down and 10 from the 33-yard line. Kowski wide to the right, and you see Bjornsson on the top. No flag. Going deep. Bjornsson
down.
Touchdown, Washington. The 11th touchdown pass of Huard, and for Bjornsson, his sixth TD reception.
The danger of the blitz in this four down area, that post corner is tough to cover. The Beavers have seen it many times this year. I'll bet it's close to half of the touchdown passes against them.
Wales has been a busy guy today. Comes on for the extra point and gets it very nicely. So Washington uses the clock and gets upfield quickly with 51 seconds remaining in the first half, leading at 17-3.
Two good things on this. Watch Damon Huard right there. You look to the right, right there. Erik Bjornsson just absolutely turned Mark Williams around over there, number 31.
Sold that route really well.
I think that little pump right there sold him a little bit, too.
Looking and, for the out pattern as opposed to...
No, to the in pattern as opposed to the out. And that little movement like that, remember Kenny Stabler used to always kind of do that little hitch with the ball. I think that froze the cornerback.
Sonny, you'd appreciate Oregon State's corners, even though they're playing man-to-man inside.
Got to hold on to the ball. Keep Don Shanklin off the field. Checking off at the line. Play clock down to one at the snap. Bjornsson, complete first down at the 30-yard line of Oregon State. Got away from William Ephraim, number 18.
Nice throw.
You're right, though, Sonny. He keeps going back to Eric, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's well, he's been his number one man so far this season. You can see why here. Did you watch Eric stick those big paws up there? He does a great job of concentrating and catching the ball in his hands.
Mm-hmm.
Should have seen the show that Bjornsson put on against Craig Newsom of Arizona State, Steve. It was something else. And Newsom, one of the best cornerbacks around. First and 10 from the 30. Going for everything. Bjornsson, touchdown! Oh, what a play to the senior, but we got a flag down in the backfield. Let's go back and see what it's all about.
Nothing but holding when it's
holding.
Down there in the middle.
You got that right. Bring it back, dogs. This is what's been going on the last two games, Sonny.
Now that, you're absolutely right.
Oh, big call.
And the hold called by Bill Richardson, the referee. See if you can find it in the line. Now tough from this angle.
Well, they're sending people like they have been most of the day. Well, there's a little bit of a jersey right there, but the guy that threw the flag was from behind. I'm not sure he could see that one. Still an excellent throw and a great route by Erik Bjornsson.
What a shot. That's the difference. Those last two patterns, the size difference with Bjornsson, huge factor. Williams not been that far off of it.
First down and 26. They've got to get third down and 7. So interesting call now for the Huskies, who are only, what, 2 of 10 on their third down conversions today.
Well, it's, what do you think, Sonny? That little quick screen if they're going to go up top or a draw?
Well, I think one thing they should look at is throwing the ball to Erik Bjornsson for the first down is running out. That seemed to work before. It's worked the last few ball games.
I'm going to the end zone with Janowski. He's got single coverage with Williams on him, and he's got the whole side of the field. Like I said, let's go to Bjornsson. Touchdown!
What a catch!
Unbelievable! Behind the head of the defender.
Wow. This is incredible. Incredible catch.
Boy, he's had one, he's had one call back today. This one counts, and he did it in great fashion.
An even tougher one. Now with seven touchdown receptions.
Well, here we go, Don. I had the right guy, but you had the right play.
Look at this.
Oh, behind Ephraim, too.
There's that size difference.
Yep, no question. No question.
That's a big-time catch, folks. John Wales. And it is good, and Washington collectively breathing a little more easily now with a 24-10 lead. The last time the Beavers met the Huskies up here, I believe the final was 45-16. That tells you how far the Beavers have come.
I remember that day. You guys let me have it pretty good.
I tried to be as nice as possible, actually.
Steve, you actually should have gone down at halftime with all those alumni down there and said hi to a few of those boys.
I'll bet there's a guy that wouldn't want to talk to or see again.
Yeah, yeah. We could find Rick Redmond in a few other guys for you.
We had some tough guys here. Medved, Redmond, boy, you had some linebackers about that. Freddie Ford.
What's like season for you? How's it feel? Today, but Oregon State's going to get football. They made some to stop this when they knew to, and big time went.
And you're like, such a tall both of us. How do you sort of manage out there on the field?
It could be a sometime. You know, when that last ride had to be, and either I was catching that or nobody was. So, it comes in handy.
Just keep it up, keep playing hard, bro.
Main thing. That's exactly right.
Back to you.
Hey, by the way, William Ephraim, the man he had to reach over for the touchdown, that 160 pounds. It's the 615-pound Eric Bjornsson.
Well, we also Eric Bjornsson is one of the best DBs in the league. Turnover when they didn't need to have.
Packed in here. Turns it out quickly to Eric Bjornsson. Bjornsson across the midfield stripe and bumped down. He's averaging about 17 and a half yards a carry. He was taken out by Jamie Webb. The Stanford Cardinal defense, a troubled defense here in 94. Jason Bisk, he's going to have his hands full today with Frank Garcia, the Washington center. The linebacking core, there's the son of Joe Gibbs, and came to Washington as a quarterback. Converted to a wide receiver, and boy, what a job he has done, averaging over 17 yards a catch, has seven touchdowns on the year.
Well, this is a return home for him. He went to Bishop O'Dowd High School over in Oakland, and speaking with him yesterday, he said, you know, Rod, I had to get 60 tickets for friends and family for this ball game. So he's got a few folks in the stands today.
Well, he didn't have trouble getting them. And out of bounds he goes. He's got a first down.
Yeah, could you be
17.
Could you be any more wide open than Bjornsson was on that play? Yeah, he runs a nice out pattern here. You'll see man coverage there. Bilal Swinton has him covered. He runs the out, and Swinton is still looking back inside and doesn't quite believe the ball is going to be thrown there. And you see Bjornsson just kind of move out to the outside, pick up the pass there. Nice catch. Drive keeps alive there. Played three games at quarterback last season for the Huskies.
From the 36. Heward to Bjornsson, and out of bounds he goes. Neither quarterback being pressured whatsoever in this game.
Yeah, Kwame Ellis is on the coverage there. Watch how wide open Bjornsson gets on this play. You see, there's about 8 or 9 yards of cushion there by the cornerback, and there really isn't a lot of reason for Stanford's defensive back to play that far off of Bjornsson. He's a big guy, about 6'6", runs about a 4'5", 4'6", 40-yard dash. Now, the condition, Lambright knows that. He's got to have his team putting points on the board as you take a look at all that rain there, Phil.
Well, it's starting to really rain hard now. Second down and 10. Three-step drop. Heward shoots it out to the far side. It's caught. And Bjornsson is taken out of bounds by Elyle Swinton. Yeah, there's no question. This Washington offense has really opened up under first-year offensive coordinator Bill Dietrich. He told me yesterday that this ball game. 7:08 to play on the second quarter. Heward again, the three-step drop up and over the top. Intended for Bjornsson. He got it, but came down out of bounds.
And came down hard out of bounds on his back and his hip. That probably knocked the wind out of him at the very least. Meanwhile, Swinton, number 9, was over on the coverage. And one of the good things for Swinton that time was that this route was run near the Stanford bench. So watch right now. When he's not looking back, his teammates on the sideline are yelling ball, so he knows to turn around to try to make a play.
Did a nice job coming down with the football as Eli Swinton was right inside his shorts on that one. Listen to this when he hits. Ouch. He came right down on his tailbone, Rod. Now he's up. I'll tell you, week in and week out, you watch football, the high school level, the college level, the pro level, and I still am amazed, as much as I've watched football, how these players...
No problem. You know, you have a player like Napoleon Kaufman, it is no problem.
Ewert on the two-point conversion. It's caught. Bjornsson's got it. And the Huskies have two. And now, break out to a 25-22 lead.
Well, Ewert found him very quickly, and Bjornsson was wide open there. It's amazing how wide open receivers are in this ball game. Phil, you take a look here, straight drop back. You wonder how Bjornsson got so wide open. He's just out there. No one covered him.
Well, I asked you at the outset, Rod, you look at this weather, and you're right. Look how wide open Bjornsson was.
So there you see from that angle that Eli Swinton was on him, and they both got tangled up there, and he was able, Bjornsson was able to bounce back out to the outside while Swinton was still on the ground.
20. One more time. Bjornsson, that's his sixth catch of the first half. Pruitt's the guy who covered him, but there's a flag down back at about the 20-yard line.
Defense, offside, penalty is declined, first down.
Bjornsson is putting on a clinic for the out pattern. Watch him run this nice route. Angles to the outside, shows inside a little bit, and Leroy Pruitt bites on the inside fake. Gets back in the picture to make a play on it, but Bjornsson is too tall and goes up real high to make the catch here. Leroy Pruitt with a great effort, but Bjornsson at 6'6 is able to get up higher and come up with the catch. And that weight room and puts all those 45-pound weights on there.
They lift shrimp trawlers up around us. Yeah. For Bjornsson. Let's see what the officials say. They're going to rule him out? Or was he taken out by Swinton? Nope, no catch.
You know, I think a little bit here, you got Hewitt who gets used to throwing that ball very high to Bjornsson because he's so tall. He puts that ball only where he can get it, but he also makes it kind of tough on him. You see him come down out of bounds here because we've consistently seen Bjornsson have to go up high.
He's got it and taken down by Leroy Pruitt. Oh, they're going to call him out of bounds. No, it's a catch. Pruitt took him down. David Walker again in the neighborhood.
Watch the route here and watch how high this ball is thrown. And Bjornsson once again going up high to make another catch. This young man is a movie fanatic, Bjornsson is. He's seen the movie. Who's...
Colbert's pass is caught over the middle by Bjornsson inside the 45 to the 43.
What made this play for the Washington Huskies was the fact that the offensive line, look at the pass protection. Billy Joe Hobart had time to look for the secondary receiver, Eric Bjornsson, number 14, for the reception.
Third down, the line to make just inside the Nebraska 45. Again, it is Bjornsson. That's twice that Eric Bjornsson has come up with a huge catch for Washington.
It has to frustrate you on defense is that you're stopping them on third down, that they're able to pick up the first down. Here you get Mark Brunell, the second team quarterback, delivering the throw. Nice catch stretching out for the reception. Eric Bjornsson, number 14.
Will Hyde. Steps on the the field. He makes a big thing happen, Mike, three times tonight.
Billy Joe Hobert put the ball right on the money on the post route. Nebraska with just a five-man rush, and you see the route. Bjornsson did a nice job of getting Tyrone Bird on his hip and keeping him there and kind of shielding him a little bit from the football. It's just a nice position catch by the body of Eric Bjornsson. Nice job.
Three catches for 74 yards, and every one of them have been big and critical plays. Third down and nine. What do you room? Bjornsson does hold on. Boy, he got that one by the fingernails, didn't he? Maurice Hipson there defensively with Godfrey back into the game now, returning. Dan Godfrey, who is quite a story. We'll talk about that in a moment.
Damon having all kinds of time back there to throw the ball. Eric Bjornsson with a great grab. You'd think he just got a snap from our long snapper on extra points or field goals, Don. The way that's been going.
Yeah.
He's had a lot of practice with those kind of throws.
Probably thinking that was another one of those Frank Garcia snaps.
But there
poor
it
Frank.
Is.
You, Frank's getting tired of hearing all the gas about his snaps. Has to play the whole game and then make long. And all the way going to Bjornsson, and I believe he's out of bounds. He is indeed out of bounds. So they took one to waste on second and one. Good idea, but very good defense.
Good
on the part of Maurice Simpson. Go ahead.
Good blocking right here, Don. Didn't give himself enough room to be, oh, he almost came up with it, but just by about a foot and a half.
And I correct myself, that's D. Grayer who played the good D.
Again, a great catch, though, by Eric Bjornsson.
Pass too short. Third down and one for Washington.
Five guy. It looked like it was a little bit of face guarding involved in there by Crutchfield. To me, that looks like face guarding, but then again, I'm not making the call.
They were awful cozy in that corner over there, weren't they?
Well, I didn't see Crutchfield looking back at the quarterback. His face was right on the receivers, never looked back once.
The face guard when you're 5'8 with your face, and he's a 6'5
okay,
too. Third and three, huge play, wide open touchdown. Yes, Eric Bjornsson, and what a nifty job of Huard getting away from the tackle attempt. Great play by Huard to get away from the rush. That had trouble written on it when they started the play, Sonny.
Well, when we see the replay, I'll know why, because there's a good look at Eric Bjornsson, 11-yard TD. Marcus Galbraith, 15, was on a safety blitz. We saw him miss an earlier tackle on Damon when we went in to score, and that time he just missed another wrap-up. He was there for the play.
Eric Bjornsson, with his third touchdown of the season, will now hold, and we assume will stay in his position for the kick. And does so. So Washington extends its lead to 10 at 27-17 with 10:49 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Bjornsson, five catches for 50 yards. None more important than this.
There's Marcus Galbraith, 15, shooting through there. Great timing. He should have made the play. Good job by Damon to avoid the tackle. And of course, there's Mr. EB wide open.
EB. So Washington over there breathing a little bit better now. More easily with 10. Beautifully for Huard. Huard will go to the end zone. Wide opens Bjornsson. Six more. Touchdown, Huskies.
First down and running the ball, the cutbacks, tremendous fake. See him pull the linebackers, all three linebackers in the center of your screen. No help underneath. One-on-one coverage out on top. He gets beat there. There goes Bjornsson right there for the touchdown. Going on behind Marlon Kerner, number 46.
Only thing that I would criticize the Huskies for is now they have to use a timeout. They're not together for their extra point. Otherwise, folks, they've been very efficient. Cover Bjornsson and pass interference is called. See who it's on down there. He was covered by Kerner. Flag came down. Kerner was draped on him. But you know, Bjorn. Watson might have pushed off the defender. Let's see what happens. That's what Kerner's arguing down there, and I believe Kerner is saying it's going the other way here. And now the Buckeyes are furious again.
They're both guys going up for the football.
Oh, that's unbelievable if they're calling that against Kerner.
That's a nice reception by Erik Bjornsson. Remember, he has been a quarterback here. Outstanding young man from Northern California, honor student.
Yeah, Dick, you know, that was a great catch.
That was a great, great catch. What did Coach say? I'm not taking advantage of his arm. I'm going to take advantage of his legs. He demonstrated it there.
First and goal. I'd say give it to number 8 and let's run the right side.
Well, if Bjornsson, number 14, goes in motion, just follow him, all right?
I'd follow Ernie Conwell, that big junior tight end, number 82, if I can find him.
They're going to try to throw it to Bjornsson, number 14.
Here it comes. He's covered. Hewer scrambling down at the 3-yard line, and it fails again.
Good defense by the Buckeyes. That's what they wanted to do. They're a hope.